Hey, my name is Ben Dolphens. I'm one of the three owners here at Divine Barrel Brewing in Charlotte, North Carolina. I'm the head brewer and head of operations here at the brewery. And this is how I Mountain Khaki. Well, I went to school up at App State, up in Boone. I started there in the mid-90s, and at that time, craft beer was kind of on an uptick, so there were more and more things kind of becoming available. And I started trying different beers here and there, whether it was parties or hanging out with friends, and started to kind of realize what was out there. Got a little excited, figured I'd try to see kind of, you know, what I could get into. And at the same time, home brewing was kind of coming much farther along than it was back in the late 70s when it got legalized. So thanks to Jimmy Carter for that. I had expressed interest to my girlfriend at the time, who's my wife now, about starting home brewing. Bought me my first homebrew kit for Christmas of 99. And I didn't even know it was gonna work. So I brewed a brown ale and bought some honey from a roadside stand in Boone. Added that, so I made a honey brown, kind of like J.W. Dundee's honey brown that was around way back then. It did totally work, and I caught the bug pretty much instantly after that, and so I started grabbing every homebrewing book I could get my hands on, try to just learn an effort to get better at brewing, homebrewing, and I've been doing that since 99, so yeah, I've been brewing ever since. So. The rest is kind of history. I actually just blame this whole brewery on my wife. It's all her fault. So my two business partners and I met through mutual friends that we had, and we all shared kind of a common interest in starting a brewery. Me having been a home brewer for a long time, it's sort of a pipe dream for a lot of home brewers to start their own thing. But Gavin and Scott also had interests in doing that. The skill sets were very different, but so we look at it as kind of like a three-legged stool. So I brought my brewing knowledge to the table. Gavin brought his service industry and restaurant experience to the table. And Scott has been in the financial industry for a long time, sort of brought that financial piece. You know, our goal with this place was to create a brewery that was appealing to as many people as possible with as wide and diverse of a tap list as we could manage. While still making sure that the beer coming out of here is as good as it possibly can be. And we strive to do that every day. And I think we've done a pretty good job, but it's still not good enough for me. So we constantly are tweaking and driving towards better and better beer. But we've been open since March of 2018. So we'll be 6 years in March of 24. I mean, legacy, is something you kind of leave behind that wasn't there before you did whatever you did. Something that leaves a long-lasting, hopefully positive impact on the people that, you know, come after you. I hope when it's all said and done that people will think and believe that Divine Barrel contributed and left behind something special to not only the Charlotte craft beer scene, but North Carolina's burgeoning craft beer scene as well. There's a ton of amazing breweries in the state and in Charlotte, and you know, everybody contributes, but hopefully, you know, Divine Barrel has made an impact on people in a number of ways, whether it's from the beer we brew or the culture we have at the brewery, the staff interactions that people have. Hopefully, you know, we've done that and continue to do that going forward until, you know, this thing's something people talk about